What's going on, y'all? This is your boy, Scattered by Nature TV, and we're here for a brand new episode of Yes for the Mess, you guys. Now, before we get into today's mess on this beautiful, beautiful Sunday morning, well, Sunday afternoon, I'm sorry, on this beautiful Sunday afternoon, we're about to get into what we have coming up on this platform, okay? So first things first, we're going to talk about the brand new season 4. We're talking about the brand new panel. Whether you like it or not, panel will be returning next Monday. That's next Monday. We will not be coming on this Tuesday as we normally would, but we will be back on next Monday for the Whether You Like It or Not panel, Potomac Edition Season 4, where we'll be discussing Potomac and nothing but Potomac. So be on the lookout for that. And we will be starting on Yocrates' channel at 9:15 Eastern Time. That's where the party would get started at, right over there at Yocrates' channel. So be on the lookout for the Whether You Like It or Not panel as we go into Season 4 for Real Housewives of Potomac. On Wednesday, we will be roasting and reviewing Love and Marriage Huntsville, okay? We will be doing that. And it will be myself, Terrence, and Josiah, and we will be over on we'll be right over here on Scattered by Nature TV talking about yesterday's episode of Love and Marriage Huntsville. So be on the lookout for that. On Thursday night, be on the lookout for the prelude featuring Latrice Rogers of Bell Collective. We're going to sit down and we're going to talk to her about what happened on the reunion. We're going to talk about what happened with the season that we didn't see. We're just going to talk about a whole lot of stuff. So be on the lookout for that on Thursday night. And also, it's Boys Night Out week, okay? It's Boys Night Out week, and we're in the halfway mark of this season already. So be on the lookout for the 5th episode of Boys Night Out on Friday night at 9, 8 Central, okay? We right over here on this channel. So be on the lookout for your favorite quintet. I don't know if Maddie will be able to do it or not. I found out later on today because I know that he's moving. So we're going to figure it. I'm going to ask him today, but we're going to have us a good show this week. Be on the lookout for it. Remember, we're at the halfway mark. You know, we only have 10 episodes, so we already at episode 5 already. So be on the lookout for that. All right, you guys. So with that being said, that's everything that we got coming up on the channel. So let's start off by getting into the tea. And today's tea, we're going to start this thing off with Mr. Jim Jones, as you guys know from We Fly High, No Lie, and you know it, Ballin'. If you don't know him from there, you know him from Love & Hip Hop Atlanta, being forever fiancé to Chrissy Lampkin, okay? Now, apparently, Jim Jones is pissed, okay? Jim Jones is mad. Jim Jones is pissed off because BET refused to have him give him access to the BET Hip Hop Awards, okay? And he basically put them on blast. So without any further ado, we're going to go ahead and look at this article that I got here from hiphopdx.com. So let's get into it, y'all. So the thing of it is, this is how it starts off. So it says, Jim Jones has put BET on blast for not allowing him to attend this week's BET Hip Hop Awards in Atlanta. On Friday, September the 30th, the Harlem rapper said that he wanted to show support for his close friend and fellow New Yorker, Fat Joe, who is set to host this year's award show, but claimed that the network would not allow him access. So he took to Instagram to show Joey Crack that he tried his best to be in attendance for the show, which takes place on Friday evening, but BET apparently shut him down and put the blame on COVID-19 protocols for not allowing extra talent guests, okay? Now, this is what he said. I was trying to go to the BET Hip Hop Awards to support my brother at Fat Joe, and this is how BET handled me, LOL, LOL. Damn, BET, I thought this was a hip hop award show, he wrote. Somebody tell Fat Joe that I tried. Don't want him to think I ain't keep my word. I told him I was coming, but BET says different. Maybe next time, tear that shit down, Joe. They still talking COVID, and the CDC says it ain't no more COVID. Also, I had requested you to participate or attend as we did in the past. Their response, thank you for your inquiry. At this time, we are unable to accommodate additional audience talent requests due to COVID-19 protocols in place. This year's show and red carpet are reserved for in-show talent nominees and select participating network partners only. Okay. Jones received report from his lobby boys partner Mano in his comment section. They playing with the lobby, shakes my head. It remains to be seen if BET will end up extending an invitation to Jim Jones after the public criticism, since he promised Joe that he'd be in the building to lend his support. Joey Crack will bring the energy for what he described as the biggest award show ever with him at the helm inside of Atlanta's Cobb Energy Center. The 22 BET Awards will air exclusively on BET on October the 4th at 9 p.m. Eastern Time. Drake leads the pack with 14 total nominations, and Trina is set to be honored with the I Am Hip Hop Award. This will be the biggest award show in history, Fat Joe told Billboard. It's truly an honor to host and produce the BET Hip Hop Awards, and I can't thank Connie and the entire BET family enough for this opportunity. We're going to celebrate music, culture, and entertainment and honor the biggest and brightest stars in the world and make this an unforgettable night full of laughs and surprises. Always remember that yesterday's host is not today's host. Okay, so that's pretty much it from hiphopdx.com. And all I'm going to say is this right here. I mean, I don't like Jim Jones. We know this already. And I'm cool with not liking him. You know, we're all, you know, whatever. But at the end of the day, it is kind of messed up that they did not allow him to be there for Joey Crack. I ain't going to lie to you. They were wrong for that. You know what I'm saying? Like, they could have extended the invite. You know, if he told Fat Joe that he was going to be there and shit like that, they could have did that for the sake of Fat Joe. I mean, they got the man hosting their show. So I'm pretty sure that the man wants his friend to be there to, you know, do that. And on top of that, they still got COVID-19 protocols. I'm not saying that they shouldn't have them, but most people don't have protocols no more for COVID-19. You know, people walking around here with no mask on no more. I'm one of them. You know, people are going to the clubs without masks on. You know, you got your select few people that still wearing masks. People are living their lives again. You know, COVID is still around, but it's not that much of a nuisance as it once was. So, you know, there's, you know, people are going back to what they know. You know, they're not doing anything that's social distancing anymore. You know, even at these reunion shows for the housewives and shit, everybody's sitting on the couch, on the same couch. You know, they not sitting in this seat, that seat, that seat, that seat over there. They ain't doing none of that. You know, they all doing what they've been doing since before the pandemic even went down. So I understand where he coming from with that, you know. And, you know, maybe he do need to put them on blast, you know what I'm saying, for the sake of, you know, making awareness to the situation. Because a lot of the times when you put people on blast like that, you know, like networks like that on blast for not doing their due diligence as they supposed to, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of like, okay, you know, yeah, it's finna be some bullshit. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's about to be some straight up bullshit, honestly. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's what I'm taking it as. So a lot of the times when you put them on blast, that's when they decide to do what you need them to do and, you know, do all that. So it's kind of like, you know, that's crazy. But, you know, hopefully, you know, Jim Jones are able to get his invite to this award show. I think that he should be there. Once again, he should be there to support his friend, and that's just that on that. So, shout out to Jim Jones for putting it all on blast, if you ask me, because BET ain't been shit for a while, but I still try to support. Anyway, next up is Real Housewives of Potomac stars Karen Huger and Mia Thornton, y'all. Okay, now, as you guys already know, the Real Housewives of Potomac will be airing next week. You know, it's a week from today, so they will be airing next week. And as you both know, these two women were once good friends. Karen was the one who introduced Mia to the cast last season, and they were a dream team. But now they're no longer in a good place after Mia took shots at Karen Huger on Instagram, or on social media. Now, this article comes from the Urban Bell Mag, and we're going to listen to what they got to say now. They said that, like last season, as you know, Mia had an eventful first season. She clashed with Candace. And what kicked off the feud with Candace is that, you know, they had a video shoot, and Candace had Chris helping her with her music career, and she branded him as her husbinger. So, you know, after all of that went down, Miss Dorothy was talking about Chris and stuff like that. And Mia had asked, you know, Miss Dorothy if Chris was being paid to manage Candace. Then Wendy went back and told Candace what was said by Mia, and it led to problems with Candace and Mia. Now, as you guys already know, when Candace confronted Mia about her actions, Mia said that she was concerned because the shoot seemed unprofessional and low budget. So that's when Candace clapped back by, you know, saying that Mia's mother was low budget. And at that time, she didn't know that Mia's mother was a recovering addict, so things escalated fast between the two. Now, interestingly enough, Karen Huger, who introduced Mia to the, it was Karen who introduced Mia to the group. And it seems as if they're falling out while filming this upcoming season, okay? So let's get into it. We waiting, okay? So, here's the thing. As we already know, Karen has had, like, a feud with Giselle and Karen. You know, it seems as though things have been repaired between Giselle and Karen and stuff like that. So we don't know if they're friends again, but I think they're in a better space at this particular point. However, Karen will still have drama playing out on this upcoming season. Now, as you guys already know, y'all, in the trailer, she had a heated confrontation with Sharice Jackson Jordan, and she threatened to get violent if Sharice said anything else about her deceased mama. Now, interestingly enough, Karen may have had another feud to play out, but the preview didn't show it. And in fact, it seems as though she's no longer on good terms with Mia Thornton. Now, last season, Mia was the newbie that Karen brought to the group. In the beginning, Wendy questioned Mia's loyalty to Karen. She thought it was shady that Mia asked for Giselle's number while being on bad terms with Karen. Now, Real Housewives of Potomac fans became aware of Mia and Karen's falling out thanks to a shady social media post that was captured by the Peach Report. During the shady exchange, Mia said that Karen's confessional hair looked like something she bought from Claire's. Mia said, "Child, no words. Did you know that Claire's was selling clip-in buns?" And in response, Karen said, "Some folks need a moment." Real Housewives of Potomac returns on Sunday, October the 9th at 8 p.m. Eastern Pacific Time on Bravo, y'all. So that's pretty much the gist of that story. Now, y'all, listen. Mia been on some bullshit. Mia been on some bullshit, okay? We got to be honest about it. Mia been on some bullshit since she came on the show. And a lot of people only like Mia because of what they saw in the trailer. We got to keep it funky. What they saw in the trailer was that Mia and Candace had gotten into this, you know, situation, had gotten into this argument or whatever. And, you know, there was letters being thrown and shit like that. And everybody was ready to call, you know, Candace out because she was in yet another altercation with another woman on the show. They was ready to call her out on it, and they was ready to blame her for that. You know what I'm saying? And so with that being said, it was just like, okay, you know, they're doing this, they're doing that. So now after that, you know, Mia, I don't know if she was well liked or not, but I know I don't like her because she does too much, in my opinion. She really do. She do too much for a moment, and she's doing too much for a moment now. Wendy did come across as if she was looking to have a problem with Miss Mia, but to me it seems like Mia is looking to have a problem with everybody else, and now she's having a problem with the very person that brought her to the show. So now she's beefing with Karen, and I really want to know, what is this beef between her and Karen? Why would they be beefing? Why would they be having an issue? Because it seems like they had like a good relationship, but you know, this is Mia's sophomore season. She got to get from up under Karen's titty and do for herself. So now she finna come for her. All I gotta say is Real Housewives of Potomac is about to give us some tea, and I am ready for the tea. Okay, so that's just pretty much that on that. So we're about to move on to the very next topic of today, and that is Miss Quad, and Dr. Heavenly. Okay, now as you guys already know, I really haven't been covering Married to Medicine this season. However, I did cover the fight between Toya and Audra, and you know, I might just start doing a House of Aaron approach when it comes down to Married to Medicine, because you know, I don't really be covering that show because I can never stay in tune with it. It seems like after season 6 or 7, I just can't stay in tune with it for whatever reason. But it's just like, child, I do be having my things about the show, child. I do. I be having my things. I be wanting to say some shit about the show, honey. You know what I'm saying? So that's just that on that. But apparently her and Dr. Heavenly was on a live. I think it was on one of Dr. Heavenly's YouTube lives or whatever. And Quad had mentioned that somebody was ready to whoop Heavenly's ass at the reunion. And with the way Heavenly's mouth set up, who wouldn't be ready to whoop her ass? I think we got audio here. So we're gonna play. I'm sorry. Ooh, Jesus. So what we're gonna do now is that we are going to because my Bluetooth speaker just did something else, child. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna play this audio from Peach Report Daily Instagram. So let's get it. Here we go, y'all.
I get an event planner this time because I was like, listen, event planners cost coin, and right now my coin is going inside my house, so I was responsible for how everything looked. Okay,
you damn sure had security,
huh?
You had security.
Well, production bought security, so we always going to have security. You know what I mean? As we should, because you almost got your ass whooped at the reunion, from what I hear. I'm just saying, I didn't see
we
it.
We can't talk about the reunion, bitch.
Well, listen.
Okay, bitch, don't
y'all
do that. It wasn't you finna whip it. It wasn't you.
But I'm too classy to fight.
It wasn't you, and I'm too classy too. I got a whole doctor's degree, and I am board certified, bitch. I'm not finna
well, act like it.
I do act like it, bitch. And this is what it act like. When you get it, bitch, then you can tell me what it act like.
I'm not really
you
interested.
You know that Gregory just got engaged. Are you how you feeling about that?
Oh, I'm very happy. I actually put a comment underneath his
post.
I did. And it's very interesting. I don't know, it may sound a little weird. But when I saw, you know, the layout of everything, I thought he did an excellent job with the proposal. And it gave me butterflies, really and truly.
So did it remind you of your proposal, or was it similar?
No, it didn't remind me of our proposal. It just made me happy for them, you know, for love. I think the butterflies came from a feeling of love, to see that they had found love. And so I was happy to see that. I had everything going on.
Okay, y'all. So that was Quar. Now, first things first, we all heard about Dr. G being engaged and getting married. And Quad had a very mature response to his engagement. I see that she's really, really and truly moved on with her life. You know, she really don't give a fuck about what Dr. G doing. Not that she ever gave a fuck in the first place, but she don't give a fuck about what Dr. G doing. You know, she has moved on. He's moved on. She's doing her thing, and she's happy for him. So I'm glad that she didn't throw no shade. She didn't come across all weird and mean and bored and all that other shit. You know, she was just like, you know, he happy, I'm happy, you know, whatever. You know, I'm glad that he's doing his thing. But the main thing that I want to talk about is Dr. Heavenly about to get an ass whooped. Now, that's something that I wasn't prepared for. Like, I did not know that Dr. Heavenly was about to get them paws put on her. I want to know who was finna put them paws on her. Was it Toya? Was it Contessa? Who was finna put them paws on Dr. Heavenly? Because y'all know that Dr. Heavenly got a mouth on her. And you know that it don't matter what it is, Dr. Heavenly be always running her mouth and always saying shit that she ain't got no goddamn business saying. Y'all know this, right? Y'all know. Don't play. Y'all know. Okay, and then they let Dr. Heavenly get away with too much shit, too. Like, all the shit that they don't let each other get away with, they let Dr. Heavenly say whatever the fuck she want to say to them, and then they let her go. But when it's somebody else, they don't say shit. You know what I mean? It's just like Dr. Heavenly can sit up there and say whatever she wants, but they don't say shit. And Dr. Heavenly do need her ass beat. I ain't gonna lie. I've been waiting on somebody to pop on her over yonder bite, child. I've been waiting on it. I ain't gonna lie. Like, I can't with Dr. Heavenly. Child, she do too much sometimes. Funny as fuck, though. I ain't gonna take that from her. She makes the show in a way, but she do too much, child, and that's really it. I'm gonna watch the reunion to see who is about to whoop her ass. Anyway, we're gonna move on to the next thing, and that is Miss Drew Sidora and Shit by Sheree, okay? Now, you know these two have been getting into it. You know these two been getting into it all season, and this feud has been pretty funny and entertaining to me. It's very fresh and entertaining, in my opinion. It's very funny to me. I ain't gonna lie to you. It's very funny. But according to Drew told us some tea about Sheree in regards to her confiscating every single thing that she gave the women at the show, okay? She talked about flipping her hair as Sonya, and she said that after the reunion was over with, Sheree took back all the items that she gave the women. And I'm guessing she was on the Ricky Smiley show, so we finna listen to what she had to say, and he was gonna come back. Let's check that out. Let's get into it, y'all. Let's get into this tea.
But honey, I saw a clip on social media of you, Drew, being real petty, honey, in the most fabulous way, honey, with Miss Sonya Richards Ross.
Not the hair flick, girl. Like, what's the story behind this moment? I mean, Sonya looked like she was ready to snatch your wig.
Was she? She ain't ready. You know what? We from Chicago, right? You know you can't poke. You can't poke and poke. You gonna get something back, okay. And that's what I did, and it was fabulous.
Just a little
flick of the hair, honey. That's all.
A little flick of the wrist.
A little flick of the hair. Yes.
Now we also saw that Sheree bought out some merch. Did you get to keep any of the products from She by Sheree?
It was giving screen printed. Is what. I was like, I didn't see this at the fashion show. And y'all want some tea? after it was over, she was literally confiscating everything. So I need all of it back. Yeah, we didn't get to keep it. I have no key by Sheree.
OMG.
Were y'all able to buy
it? They made a grand entrance bringing the rack out and everything. She picked it. Did Andy get to keep it?
I don't know, but she was confiscating it all.
He put his shirt on
and took it right back off.
Drew is fucking hilarious, child. Drew is funny. I don't care what baby, I don't care what y'all say about Drew. Drew is fucking funny, okay? First of all, I didn't care about Drew flipping her hair at Sonya. I can't stand Sonya, but hopefully she has, is getting better next season. But I don't care. I love Drew. I don't care. Drew would take on anybody. Drew will shade anybody, and I'm here for it. I'm here for it. I don't care what she say. But Sheree is a fraud. She a fraud. How you gonna get on folks on She by Sheree and then take it back? That type of shit is that. But the problem with really no She by Sheree, no way. Because Sheree is a fraud, child. Sheree is a fraud, honey. She is a fraud. And at this point, we all got to realize that this woman is a fraud. Like, Drew is fucking hilarious, honestly. Like, Sheree is a joke. And she loves to throw around this whole respect the OG thing that she does. And there's nothing to respect about Sheree. Honestly, there's nothing to respect about Sheree. Sheree is full of it. Sheree is full of shit. I'm gonna need for her to go somewhere and sit her ass down. Honestly, like, I don't like her. And it's just that she makes herself look stupid at every fucking turn. She makes herself look stupid at every fucking turn. Okay. Like, for real, for real. Like, honestly. Like, I feel like it is what it is. Like, it's just, I don't know. It is what it is. It's just crazy to me how, you know, Sheree loves to throw this OG thing out there and she ain't about a damn thing. She just not. Like, I don't see it for Sheree. And there was one time where I used to defend Sheree down. Like, I used to stay defending Sheree down all the time, but she's indefensible at this point. It is really nothing else to be said. Child, fuck Sheree. We're going to move on to the next thing, child, with her cheap ass. Last story of the day is Miss Remy Ma, honey. Miss Remy Ma. Now, there are reports out there, child, that Miss Remy Ma was supposed to be on the Real Housewives of New York, honey. She's supposed to be on the Real Housewives of New York, but it was one big hurdle that stopped her from being on the Real Housewives of New York. And this is on the TMZ, so we're going to talk about this. So apparently, Remy Ma was in early talks to become the first rapper turned Real Housewife, but she ran into a major problem because as any realtor would tell her, it's about location, location, location. Sources familiar with the situation tells TMZ that Real Housewives of New York star Ebony K. Williams brought Remy's name to casting several months ago for the reality series, suggesting that Remy would be a great addition to the show. We're told that the casting team had a virtual chat with Remy Ma and the conversation went really well, but they hit a huge roadblock when they found out the Bronx-born MC now lives in New Jersey full-time. Our sources say that the rapper used to have an apartment in Midtown Manhattan, but she doesn't anymore. At the time she was recommending the casting, it was still believed that she had ties to NYC. While the Bravo series is historically loose about the cast's wife status, they're pretty strict when it comes to geography. So all convos with Remy about the Housewives of New York City ended. We're told that well-known NYC newscaster Tamsin Fadal from the CW affiliate Pix 11 was also considered, but ultimately that didn't work out either. Bravo hasn't officially announced a new cast for season 14, but as reported in April, Housewives honcho Andy Cohen announced that the network is completely rebooting and recasting Real Housewives of New York after 13 seasons. Sadly, Remy won't be going all the way up on that list. Y'all, when I tell y'all this, baby, I would have been all in it. Okay, I would have been all in it. I don't care what nobody say. I would have been all for Remy Ma being on Real Housewives of New York City. I would have been here for Remy Ma, okay? Like, I know that Remy Ma was on Love & Hip Hop, whatever, but Real Housewives of New York City need a facelift at this point. Because most of the women that's on there, they're going to Real Housewives of New York Legacy, right? It's Bethany, like Ramona, Luann, I think Sonya, all them going to the legacy cast. So why not bring in a new generation of NYC women? But I don't see why her living in New Jersey would be a fucking problem. There's a lot of people that live in New Jersey, but they get on their fucking train and go to New York to go to work. I mean, let's be real. A lot of the people that was on Love and Hip Hop New York, they lived in New Jersey. All of them. Olivia lived in New Jersey. I think Tahiri lived in New Jersey. Ra Ali lived in Jersey. None of them folks lived in NYC. Half of them lived in Jersey. They didn't live in NYC, y'all. A lot of these folks live in suburbs right across the water. So I don't understand why that would be a problem. But hell, if y'all don't want to get home on Real Housewives in New York City, hell, get on New Jersey. Shit, I want to see Remy. Like, I look, I know that she really, people feel like she don't fit with them, but I could see Remy right now on Housewives in New York City. They would not want it with Remy. Like, Remy would have that seat next to Andy Cohen every fucking season. Okay, I would be here for it. I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I would definitely be here for Remy Ma being on Housewives in New York City. Hopefully they fucking rethink that decision. Because, baby, that would be good for the show. I don't care what none of y'all say. I don't care what none of y'all say. That would be so good for the show. And, baby, I would definitely be watching it. I would definitely be watching it. I don't care what none of y'all got to say about it, period. Because that would be so good. I will, because I haven't watched Housewives in New York City in so many years now. Because I used to love, listen, don't stone me for this. But I used to love me some Ramona. I used to love Ramona. I loved Ramona. I loved Sonya and I loved Alex. I used to love them. Absolutely adore those women. But I don't like them no more. I don't like them no more, child. So, can't do it. Can't do it, child. Can't do it. Can't do it. Can't do it. Can't do it. No, ma'am. But that's all I got, though. That's all I really got on that, child. So with that being said, child, that's pretty much it. Like I said, I really hope they rethink that because Remy will be good for that show. She'll turn that shit upside down. And baby, I will definitely be tuned in. I definitely be reviewing it and all that shit. Okay. Get Remy on the Housewives of New York City. But anyways, with that being said, y'all, this be your boy, Scotty by Nature TV. Be sure to like, rate, comment, subscribe, and share this video. And also be sure to click on that notification bell so you can be notified whenever Scotty by Nature TV drops a video. If you want to follow me on any form of social media, my Twitter, Instagram, and my TikTok will be in the description box down below, okay? And if you want me to follow you back on Instagram, all you got to do is hit me up in the DMs with the hashtag message Scotty Gang. With that being said, you guys, your boy's out of here, and as I will leave you guys with some promos, I will talk to you guys later. Bye, y'all.
What's up, guys? It's your boy Tramel. I just wanted to say that I have a new project that's out. It's called Mixed Feelings. It's on all streaming platforms. I would hope that you would go and check it out. It's a really good feel of an album. It's got everything you need and more. It's got R&B, it's got a little bit of pop, it's got a little bit of hip hop. It's everything that you need and more. It's out all streaming platforms, like I said. Please check me out. And you can also follow me at @IAM_Tramel. That's @IAM_TRAMEL. Check me out. I hope to hear from you.